Hello everyone, welcome to Aspiring Student YouTube channel. Staff Selection Commission, SSC, has released some important instructions or guidelines for the students who are going to give their SSC examinations, okay, upcoming SSC examination in online mode. So there are some general instructions provided to the candidates and as well as some COVID-19 guidelines from the Staff Selection Commission. So these two things are very, very important, my dear friends. The main reason to provide these instructions is because of this pandemic situation, COVID-19. So we should follow the guidelines given by the SSC. So let me explain you the instructions very clearly. General instructions for the candidates. The first one is, the candidates are advised to reach the center as per the time slot indicated against the reporting or entry time in the admit card. This is very, very important thing, my dear friends. See, if you are an aspirant of both banks and SSC, you know these guidelines and the COVID-19 guidelines and the general instructions very well. But if you are the aspirant of only SSC, this video is specially for you. And this is very, very important, my dear friends. And you should follow these guidelines very strictly. Okay. So the first thing is, the candidate should reach their examination venue as per the time slot. Okay. As per the time slot mentioned on your admit card. So for each aspirant, there will be different time slot given to reach the examination venue. So the reason behind this is to maintain the social distance norms and to avoid the spread of coronavirus. Okay, my dear friends. Next one, candidates should note that no candidate will be allowed entry after the entry closing time in any circumstance or due to any reason. Gates will be closed strictly at entry closing time. So these things will be followed very strictly. And this is not important for us. But the second one is not important for us. We are preparing to get the government job. Then why will we reach the examination venue lately? We will be at before 30 minutes or 1 hour. Okay. And next, the important thing is, the third one, candidate should invariably bring the following at the time of reporting for the examination. Next, first one is admission certificate. So admission certificate is nothing but your admit card. Next, two copies of the latest colored passport size photograph. So you have to bring two photographs, my dear friends. And next one, at least one valid photo bearing identity proof in original, okay, with clear photograph. And you have to carry one ID proof, okay, and you have to carry one ID proof with clear photograph on that. Okay, my dear friends, and please bring this ID card with the photo proof and a duplicate of it. Okay, it's better to carry original ID with photo and a duplicate of it. Okay, and next one, D. If the photo identity card does not contain the complete date of birth, very important thing, my dear friends. So whatever the ID proof that you carry, if it is not containing the complete date of birth, that is date, month and year, you have to carry one more certificate where your date, month and year is clearly mentioned. Okay, this is very, very important. And the certificates that allowed here has been written, you just go through it. Okay, my dear friends. Next, and mismatch of this date of birth will not be allowed to write the examination, my dear friends. Okay, keep it in your mind. And next one, important one, that is face mask. You have to carry the face mask, my dear friends. So because of this pandemic situation, these things are very, very important. Face mask, normal face masks it's enough. It is not mandatory to carry N95 mask. Any face mask is enough, my dear friends. Okay, next one, hand sanitizer. Carry a simple hand sanitizer which is 50 ml which is available in the market. Next one, transparent water bottle and printout of COVID-19 self-declaration form, okay, with the admission certificate. Very important thing is carrying a face mask and water bottle, and print out of COVID-19 self declaration form. These three are very, very important. Very, very important, my dear friends. Okay, you have to carry the self declaration form which is given with your admit card. So earlier we have seen the admit card as one page is for where we have seen one is for venue and the next one is for general instructions. Next is for the general instructions. But right now we will read three pages of your admit card. One is same as three, that is examination venue play. Okay, one is for to mention the examination venue, and next general instructions, and next finally we have COVID-19 self-declaration form. We have to carry these three copies. We have to carry all these three copies, my dear friends, along with your admit card. So whenever you download your admit card, all the three copies will be downloaded. Next one, these things are not very important. Only the important things I will discuss here. Okay, only the important things I will discuss here. Okay, this all these things are not much important for us. Next, let's see the advisory for COVID-19. Sorry, advisory for candidates regarding COVID-19. So this is important, guys. The first one is general instructions. We know these things very well. The general instructions. Okay, what we have to carry and what we have. Okay, what we have to carry and what we not to carry for the examination. But the important thing is the new guidelines for the COVID-19. Advisory for the candidates regarding COVID-19. So see, Staff Selection Commission will implement social distancing norms during the conduct of its computer-based examination in adherence to the Government of India guidelines in the present scenario of COVID-19. To ensure health and safety of the candidates. So because of this pandemic situation, some of the guidelines has been given by the Government of India. Okay, and they are telling us that Staff Selection Commission is following the guidelines given by the Government of India for the COVID-19. We will follow the guidelines very strictly, okay, in order to ensure the safe and health of the candidates. Appropriate precautionary measures have been taken by the commission for fair and transparent conduct of examination without compromising on the safety of examiners and examinees. Candidates are required to adhere to the guidelines for the social distancing and hygiene in their own interest. This is very, very important. Okay, my dear friends. Sorry. Very, very important. You have to maintain the social distance. You have to maintain the social distance. Okay, and don't share your things or any belongings with others, and don't take the belongings of others. We don't know who is carrying this COVID-19 virus. Okay, so because of this reason, I'm strictly guiding you this. Don't share your belongings to others and don't take the belongings of others. Okay, my dear friends, next one. The first instruction is, in light of COVID-19 pandemic, the candidates are advised to reach the venue of the examination well before gate closure time as to avoid last minute crowding at the entry gate. So these things I have mentioned at the first of the video. Next, on reaching the examination venue, candidates are advised to follow social distancing norms and maintain distance of 6 feet between two candidates. Yes. So in the earlier days, we will enter into the examination hall, okay, in a crowdly manner. But today, because of this pandemic situation, for each time, one of the candidates sent into the examination hall by maintaining six feet distance between two candidates. And once, while entering into the examination hall, they will test your body. Okay, they will check your body temperature, as well as they will ask if there are any symptoms of COVID-19 or are you a COVID positive patient earlier. These things will be asked by you and checked by the examination venue. Okay. Next one, Mapping of candidate roll number and lab number will not be displayed. Very important thing. So you know these things very well. In the past days, if you write the any exam, so there will be a notice board. Okay, there will be a notice board. Okay, where the our roll numbers and room numbers are displayed. But taking this pandemic situation, it is not important to display a notice board with display a notice board with our roll numbers and room numbers. The reason is, see, you know the reason very well. See, whenever there is a notice board, 10 to 15 students will gather there and they will discuss there. And we don't know who is carrying this virus in these 10 to 15 people. And if we touch with each other, then this virus will be spread to one person to other person. So to avoid the spreading of this virus, okay, not only the SSC, every organization has cancelled to display the roll numbers and room numbers as you have seen earlier, okay, on the notice board. These things has been cancelled. Then how you get your room number and lab number? So once you enter into the examination hall, at the entry gate, okay, see, you can see here, they have given, I think, will be provided to the candidates individually at the time of entry, after verification of their admission certificate and ID proof. So once if you enter into the examination hall, they will identify your admit card and ID proof, and after checking your admit card and ID proof, they will allot you a room number and lab number, and after entering into their lab, they will take a photocopy of you. Okay, they will capture a photo of you, and after that, they will allot you a system number. My dear friends. Next, facility for hand sanitizer will be available at the entry of gate and also inside the examination venue. All candidates are required to sanitize their hands. Okay, this is very, very important, guys. Sanitizing of your hands. Next one, fifth one. Contactless candidate verification will be conducted by the flashing of admit card and a valid photo ID proof at a document verification desk. Okay. A ballpoint pen. Yes, this is important. Ballpoint pen and rough sheets will be placed at your computer desk. Okay. They will place earlier before you reach into your examination venue. Okay, my dear friends. And if you are in need of extra rough sheets, whenever if you ask the extra rough sheets, they will provide you that extra rough sheets, my dear friends. And after completion of your exam, no one is going to take your rough sheets, okay, by reaching you. And you have to carry your own rough sheets and you have to drop in the drop box, okay, which is kept outside of your examination hall. Next one, candidates with COVID-19 positive and the symptoms of COVID-19 are not allowed to write the exam. And if your body temperature is more than 99.14 degrees Fahrenheit and 37.3 degrees Celsius, are also not allowed to write your exam. Okay, guys. And next one, hand gloves is up to your wish. It is not mandatory, but the mandatory things are face mask, admit card, self-declaration form, ID proof, and two photocopies. Okay, and two photocopies, my dear friends. So how will they check? How will they check your body temperature, etc.? So you know the thermogens. So they will test. They will check your body temperature with the thermogens. If it is up to the permissible limits, they will allow you to write the exam. If it is not in the permissible limits, okay, you are not allowed to write the exam, my dear friends. Next one, you can see the left, this one. Rough sheets will be dropped by the candidates in a designated box at the exit of examination lab. Okay, just now I have told you these things. Next one. The most important thing, COVID-19 self-declaration form. This is you have to carry for your examination. Okay. Extra sheet that you have to carry for your exam. What is that? COVID-19 self-declaration form. Very, very important, my dear friends. You have to carry this. If you doesn't carry this COVID-19 self-declaration form, they won't allow you to write the exam. They won't allow you to write the exam. Okay. Do remember this. Whenever you download your admit card, you will get three pages. One page is for your examination, okay, to see your examination venue. Second page is general instructions, and the next one is COVID-19 self-declaration form. You have to carry this. See, I hereby declare that I have not been tested positive for coronavirus or identified as a potential carrier of COVID-19 virus, and I am also not having any of the symptoms related to COVID-19. So after this, what you have to do is, you have to fill all these blanks. First one is candidate name, candidate roll number. The name should be written, okay, the name should be similar with on your admit card. So however your admit card is, however your name is printed on your admit card, the same name, okay, without changing, write the same name here. Means, see why I'm telling this thing, someone will write the surnames, okay, in front of their name, and some after your name. Don't do these things. Write your name as it is printed on the your admit card. However your name is printed on the admit card, just copy and paste it here. You have to write your own. Okay, these things should be filled by your own, my dear friends. Next one, candidate roll number, exam name, exam date, exam shift, exam venue name. Next, finally, signature of the candidates. So all these things should be filled by yourself, and you must carry this COVID-19 declaration form for your exam. Okay, so these are the important guidelines given by the Staff Selection Commission, my dear friends, and the same things are available in Hindi also. Okay, and I will provide you the official link of SSC, that is ssc.nic in the description box, and you can download this PDF. Okay, my dear friends, and you can see the same things have written in Hindi. So to be user friendly, I have discussed in the English language. Okay guys, so I hope that you have understood these guidelines given by the Staff Selection Commission very clearly. And if you have any doubts with this, you can ask me in the comment section, my dear friends. And if you like this video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to share this video and this valuable information with your friends. So thanks for watching, guys. Thank you.